What do you do with the embryos that you're not going to use?
Well, we have this problem already, just through what's now old-fashioned IVF, because when couples go through IVF, they produce large numbers of embryos, generally. They only implant or transfer several of them. So in the United States alone, we believe there's about 400,000 excess embryos in storage. There's not much you can do with these embryos. You can either keep them in storage indefinitely, which is what many people are choosing to do. You can destroy them, which is something which most people don't want to do.
Right.
You can transfer them, but most people don't want to have necessarily that many children. Or you can use them for research. And this is where, when we talk about human embryonic stem cells,
this is what we're talking about.
This is where the stem cells would be coming from so these extra embryos.
So there is a massive supply, and
yes,
there's certainly demand, but there is, now we actually have government regulation.
That's right. This is not allowed. That's right.
Is it allowed internationally?
Yes. Yes, so the United States, and there's a huge paradox here, whereas with regards to fertility, the United States is something of a Wild West. Pretty much anything goes.
Until.
That's right. But with regards to stem cell research, the United States is one of the most restrictive countries in the world. And so it's basically, stem cell research is by no means illegal, but the scientists who want to do embryonic stem cell research can't use federal funds.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.